Hi everyone, welcome to day two of VBS. I am Miss Julie.
And I'm Miss Caitlin.
Yes, and I'm the chief architect on this construction site.
And I'm the chief crane leader.
Yes, and today we are gonna have the best time of day two. And we heard about things that you were learning yesterday. One of the things was that Jesus chooses to love you and me. And we thought that was the best news we'd heard all day. What about you, Caitlin? Do you like that news?
Mm-hmm. I liked it a lot.
Yes. He doesn't love us because we're extra nice or extra smart. He just loves us because he wants to. Mm-hmm. And I also heard that you had a Bible verse that is also one of my favorite in the whole Bible. It's called Philippians 1:6, and Miss Caitlin is going to read it for you. And if you have already learned it, you can say it with her, okay?
Alrighty. Being confident of this, that he who began good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Philippians 1:6.
Thank you. And let's say where you find that again. Ready?
Philippians 1:6.
Wonderful. And I love that verse because it reminds me that even if I mess up really bad, God is going to keep working on me and in me until I meet him in heaven, and he's never going to give up. So, with that said, we have a new story today, and it was going to be really, really special, but before that, we have a game, because we love to take breaks sometimes on our construction site and play some games, get to know each other, and so we have this handy-dandy toolbox that Miss Caitlin brought, and it has lots of different colored tools. I want you to see if you can think of the name of each tool as we pick them out, okay? So, Miss Caitlin, can you show us your first tool?
We have a hammer. Good job.
Okay, so a purple hammer. Purple means, Miss Caitlin, tell us what your favorite hobby is.
My favorite hobby is probably to sing.
Ooh, singing. When you're singing, you know what I'm probably doing? Dancing. Probably so. Okay. Well, I want to know what you guys' favorite hobby is. So the next time I see you in in-person church, please come tell me. Okay? All right. Let's see what the next color is. Ooh, a blue screw.
Screw.
Mm-hmm. That you would use to put lots of wood together and things together on your construction site. Caitlin, what is your favorite sport?
Basketball.
Basketball, shooting some hoops. Boom, baby.
Yes.
Okay, I like basketball too, everyone. What about?
A nut.
Ooh, okay, an orange nut. And this is kind of the gross one, okay? Miss Caitlin, what is your least favorite food?
I do not like cauliflower.
Oh, except I love cauliflower. I do not like boiled okra.
Ooh. Mm. What foods do you not like? I don't like that one either.
Okay, what's next, Miss Caitlin?
Our last color.
Ooh.
A wrench.
A red wrench. So, Miss Caitlin, this is my favorite. What is your favorite sweet treat?
Ooh, I love milk chocolate.
Wait a minute. Do you have some milk chocolate?
I certainly do.
Ooh!
I love me some milk chocolate M&Ms.
Yum. Okay, well, I just happen to have my favorite sweet treat, too. Skittles. Especially when they're sprinkled over frozen yogurt.
That sounds delicious.
Yes. So, I hope that you've enjoyed getting to know us a little bit better. And the next time we see you in person, we want to hear what your favorite things are. And maybe you can talk about that with your families. And you might learn something new. You never know. And as we are finishing up our game, it's time for our lesson. You ready? Okay, so since we are here at VBS, it's so exciting. This is, I know we do a lot of different things, But the most important thing we do is all throughout the day we learn about God's true word. And this part of our video is my favorite because it's the best story, okay? Or it's one of the best stories. There's so many good ones. But today we're learning about a story in Acts 26, the book of Acts, chapter 26, okay? Mm-hmm. So Paul was in prison. Oh, wow. He was chained up in prison. And we're going to learn about why he was in prison. And he was in a place called Caesarea. And he had been actually teaching people that Jesus is the Messiah, that he loved them. But there were some people in Caesarea that did not like that. And so they had him locked up in prison. But he used that opportunity to love people and worship Jesus and sing and pray. And he was so kind and such a strong example in prison that he got the attention of Festus. Festus was the governor. Can you say Festus?
Festus. Can you say Festus? Good job.
Okay, so Festus was talking to the king about this guy named Paul. And the king, his name was Agrippa, he said, I will meet with this Paul. Now, I don't know about you, but if I was in prison, I may not have brought my toothbrush.
Ooh, you think? Can you say ew?
Ooh. And I probably don't have my best favorite clothes with me. It would be a really hard thing to be told, you are going to meet with a king today right out of prison. But that's what happened to Paul. But was Paul scared, or did he say, no, never, I can't do that?
Mm-mm.
No, he didn't. Instead, he went right up to King Agrippa, and he explained so well what God had done in his life. And so, in Acts 26, you know one thing that he says that I really, really like?
What did he say?
He said, one day I was walking down the road, heading to Damascus, minding my own business. I was on my way to put some Christians in prison. Because Paul believed that people who said Jesus was the Messiah were doing the wrong thing. And so he thought he was pleasing God by throwing people into prison, and even worse. And so he was walking with some friends on the way to Damascus, and suddenly something crazy happened. Okay, Miss Caitlin, can you show us what it might have looked a little bit like? Do you see that light? Suddenly, a light shone down from heaven so bright that it was brighter than the sun. And Paul and all his friends just fell down. They couldn't believe it. They didn't know what it was. And so, thank you, Miss Caitlin. You can put the light down. And so, after that, Paul heard a voice, and no one else heard the voice. And do you know what the voice said?
What did it say?
It said, Paul, why do you persecute me? And persecution, can you explain maybe what persecution is, Miss Caitlin?
Persecution is punishing someone for what they believe in.
That's right. Persecution means hurting or punishing someone for what they believe. And Jesus spoke to Paul from heaven to say, Paul, why do you persecute me? But Paul didn't know who was talking. And he said, who are you? And Jesus told him, he said, I am Jesus whom you are persecuting. And see, Paul learned that when he was hurting other Christians, he was hurting Jesus. It was hurting Jesus' heart to see all of the people who were following him be hurt by Paul. Immediately, Paul changed his heart. Immediately, he accepted that Jesus was going to forgive him. He turned from his sin and he started following Jesus. He realized that Jesus would forgive him. Even though, do you know what he called himself?
What?
The chief of sinners. That means like the biggest one, the boss. He was the sinner boss because he was hurting people that Jesus loved, right? But even Paul was forgiven, and not only forgiven, but he was used by God, right? And so that is a great lesson we're learning about today. And we even have a fun poster that has our special word on it.
Forgiveness.
Yes, forgiveness. Forgiveness is the greatest gift. Because you know what? We have a verse that Paul wrote later, and it's Romans 5:8.
Can you say Romans 5:8?
Good job.
Good job.
I tell you what, I wonder if you guys can see it. I'm going to hold it up a little bit and see if you guys can read it with us. It says, "But God demonstrates his own love for us in this, while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." Romans 5:8. And so even while Paul was still sinning, Jesus died on the cross for him, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so Paul wasn't looking for Jesus, but Jesus was looking for Paul, right? And so we are so thankful that God loves us so much that he chooses to love us even when we don't deserve it. And so today, as you guys keep going to your next video, whenever you're finished with your VBS, don't forget
your kids' activity book.
Yes, and Miss Caitlin, can you turn it to day two and just see what things they might get to do today?
Ooh, see, day two. Ooh, we are going to...
Ooh, I think I see a dump truck. You better go figure out what you're gonna do in there, okay? Thank you so much, and now please have your parents turn on the... craft video. All right, Miss Caitlin and Miss Julie, out.
Out.